Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Fluid Mechanics and Machines. This is lecture number 3.3 in Fluid Mechanics, and we are going to solve problems in the fluid statics. In the earlier lectures in the fluid statics, we discussed the total force and the center of pressure of horizontal plane, vertical plane and submerged curved surface. Total pressure, center of pressure, buoyancy, center of buoyancy and metacentric height. And in this lecture, we solve problems in the fluid statics. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in the fluid statics. Example number 1. Determine the total pressure on a circular plate of diameter 1.8 meter which is placed vertically in water in such a way that the center of the plate is 3.2 meter below the free surface of water. Find the position of the center of pressure. And this is the arrangement. Diameter is 1.8 meter, h bar is equal to 3.2 meter. So h bar is the height of the center from the free surface of water. Area of the plate A equal to pi by 4 d square, substituting pi by 4 into 1.8 square equal to 2.5434 meter square. And the total pressure on the surface of the plate F equal to rho g A into h bar. So rho is 1000, g is 9.81, area equal to 2.5434 and 3.2 multiplied by 3.2 equal to 79842.4 Newton. The moment of inertia of the circular plate Ig equal to pi d power 4 divided by 64, which is pi into 1.8 to the power 4 divided by 64 equal to 0.515 meter to the power 4. The position of center of pressure H star equal to Ig by A into H bar plus H bar, which is 0.515 divided by 2.5434 into 3.2 plus 3.2 equal to 3.263 meter. Then the answer to the problem, the total pressure on the surface is 79842.4 Newton and the position of the center of pressure equal to 3.263 meter. Example number 2, a caisson for closing this entrance to a dry dock is of a trapezoidal form, 18 millimeter wide at the top, 10 meter wide at the bottom with a 6 meter deep. Find the total pressure and the center of pressure on the caisson if the water in the outside is just level with the top and the dock is empty. So this is the arrangement, the trapezoidal plate of top side B equal to 18 meter, bottom side A equal to 10 meter and depth H equal to 6 meter. And the area of the plate of the trapezoidal plate A equal to A plus B divided by 2 into H, 10 plus 18 divided by 2 into 6 equal to 84 meter square, and the distance of the center of gravity from the free surface of water H bar equal to 2A plus B divided by A plus B into H by 3, substituting 2 into 10 plus 18 divided by 10 plus 18 into 6 by 3 equal to 2.71 meter. The total pressure on the surface F equal to rho g A into h bar, which is 1000 into 9.81 into 84 into 2.71 equal to 22,33,148.4 Newton. The moment of inertia of the trapezoidal plate Ig equal to A square plus 4AB plus B square divided by 36 into A plus B into h to the power 3. Substituting numerical values, 10 square plus 4 into 10 into 18 plus 18 square divided by 36 into 10 plus 18 into 6 to the power 3 equal to 245.142 meter to the power 4. So the position of the center of pressure H star equal to Ig by A H bar plus H bar equal to 245.142 divided by 84 into 2.71 in plus 2.71 equal to 3.78 meter. So the answer to the problem, total pressure on the surface is 22,33,148.4 Newton. And the position of the center of pressure 3.78 meter. Example number 3. A circular opening 4 meter diameter in a vertical side of a tank is closed by a disc of 4 meter diameter which can rotate about the horizontal axis. Determine the force on the disc. Number 2. The torque required to maintain the disc in the equilibrium in the vertical position when the head of water above the horizontal diameter is 4 meter. and this is the arrangement. We have a tank and there is an opening of circular opening closed by a circular disc of 4 meter diameter, and the H bar, the distance of center free surface, the distance between free surface of water and the center of the disc H bar equal to 4 meter. Answer, the given data, diameter equal to 4 meter, H bar equal to 4 meter, and the area of the plate, A equal to pi by 4 d square, which is pi by 4 into 4 square equal to 12.56 meter square, and the total pressure on the surface is F equal to rho g into A H bar, 1000 into 9.81 into 12.56 into 4 equal to 492,854.4 Newton. The moment of inertia of the circular plate, Ig equal to pi d power 4 divided by 64, which is pi into 4 to the power 4 divided by 64 equal to 12.56 meter to the power 4. Then position of the center of pressure, H star equal to Ig by A into H bar plus H bar equal to 12.56 divided by 12.56 into 4 plus 4 equal to 4.25 meter. The torque required to maintain the disc in the equilibrium in the vertical position, that is equal to moment of the pressure force about the horizontal diameter. So, which is F into H star minus H bar, which is 492,854.4 into 4.25 minus 4 equal to 123,213.6 Newton meter. So, the answer to the problem, the total pressure on the surface 492,854.4 Newton. And the torque rate required to maintain the disc in the equilibrium in the vertical position equal to 123,213.6 Newton meter. Example number 4. A circular plate 4 meter diameter is immersed in water in such a way that its greatest and least depth below the free surface are 4 meter and 1.5 meter respectively. Determine the total pressure on one surface of the plate and the position of the center of pressure. So, this is the given data. So, the area of the plate, look at the plate, circular plate is immersed. So, at it is actually this is the plate, QB is the plate and this is the inclined plate. The plate is put vertically inclined. The dimensions, the greatest and least depth below the free surface. So, this is the greatest depth 4 meter, this is the least depth 1.5. meter, and the diameter of the disc is 4 meter. So, you look at the height, AB is the least depth, PQ is the highest depth, and this is the center of the disc, CD is the center of the disc. Now, we have to calculate the area of the plate, A equal to pi by 4 d square, which is pi by 4 into 4 square equal to 12.56 meter square. The distance of center of gravity from the free surface, sin theta we have to calculate. First, we have to calculate the sin theta. So, this is the theta angle, theta sin theta equal to FQ. So, FQ divided by BQ. What is BQ? BQ is this length. BQ is the length, FQ opposite side by hypotenuse. So, FQ equal to PQ minus AB. So, FQ this length equal to the total length PQ minus AB. So, PQ equal to 4, AB equal to 1.5. And BQ equal to 4. PQ equal to 4. BQ is the diameter of the disc, which is also 4. So, 4 minus 1.5 divided by 4 equal to 0.625 angle sin theta. Now, H bar, this distance H bar equal to CD. So, CD is the H bar, which is CE plus BD sin theta. So, CE, which is CE? CE is the 1.5 meter. CE equal to 1.5 meter, and the small length, which is 2 into BD sin theta. So, BD is the this length. So, this BD into sin theta, 2 into 0.625 equal to 2.75 meter. So, H bar this length CD equal to 2.75 meter. Now, the total pressure on the surface, this is F equal to rho G A into H bar, which is 1000 into 9.81 and 12.56 into 2.75 equal to 338,837.4 Newton. And the moment of inertia of the circular plate, Ig equal to pi d power 4 divided by 64. So, pi into 4 power 4 divided by 64 equal to 12.56 meter to the power 4. And the position of the center of pressure, you have to calculate H star equal to Ig plus A into H bar plus H bar equal to 12.56 divided by 12.56 into 2.75 plus 2.75 equal to 2.89 meter. So the answer to the problem, total pressure on the surface 338,837.4 newton, and the position of the center of pressure 2.89 meter. Example number 5. Each gate of a lock is 6 meter high. So the lock, actually this is the lock, the height is 6 meter, right? Height is 6 meter, is supported by two hinges placed on the top and bottom of the gate. There are two hinges, so placed at the top and bottom of the gate. When the gates are closed, they make an angle of 120 degree. So look at the plan view. So the when the gates are closed together, the angle is 120 degree. Width of the gate, width of the lock is 5 meter. So width of the lock, it is given by 5 meter. So this is the width of the lock, and this is the height of the lock. If the water level are 5 meter and 3 meter and the upstream and the downstream side of the respectively. So this is the upstream side, 5 meter height. This is the downstream side, 3 meter height. Determine the magnitude of the force on the hinges due to the water pressure. So this is the front view, elevation of the water gate, and this is the top view of the water gate, and C and A, they are the hinges. So this is the hinge, this is also the hinge. Now we calculate height of the lock gate 6 meter. So the total height is 6 meter, width of the lock gate 5 meter, which is given in the plan, and width of each lock gate L. Width of each gate, lock gate L equal to AD by cos theta. So AD is the AD by cos theta. So cos 30, this angle is how, because this inflow angle is 120 and these angles are 30, 30. So this is 30, this is 30, because the included angle of the triangle is 180 degree. So 2.5 cos 30 equal to 2.887 meter. Height of water on the upstream side, which is given 5 meter. Height of the water on the downstream side, H2 equal to 3 meter. So these are all the data given, and the entire problem is described in the form of a diagram. Area on the upstream side, A1 equal to H1 into L, which is 5 into 2.887 equal to 14.435 meter square. Height of center of gravity on the upstream side, H1 bar equal to H1 divided by 2 equal to 5 by 2, which is 2.5 meter. And total pressure on the upstream side, F1 equal to rho GA into H1 bar, which is 1000 into 9.81 into 14.435 into 2.5 equal to 354,018.4 newton. And this force F1 will be acting at a distance H1 by 3, which is 5 by 3 equal to 1.67 meter from the bottom of the gate. And similarly, area on the downstream side, A2 equal to H2 into L, which is 3 into 2.887. which is 8.661 meter square. Height of the center of gravity on the downstream side, H2 bar equal to capital H2, the height of water in the downstream side divided by 2, which is 3 by 2 equal to 1.5 meter. And the total pressure on the downstream side equal to F2 equal to rho GA H2 bar, which is 1000 into 9.81 into 8.661 into 1.5 equal to 127,446.6 newton. And this force F2 will be acting at a distance H2 by 3, which is 3 by 3 equal to 1 meter from the bottom. Now, the resultant water pressure on each gate, F equal to F1 minus F2, which is 354,018.4 minus 127,446.6 equal to 226,571.8 newton. Let the height, X is the height of the force F from the bottom. So, we have to calculate the x, the distance at which this force is acting. We assume x is the distance at which the total resultant force is acting on each gate. Taking the moment, f into x equal to f1 into 1.67 minus f2 into 1. So 226,571.8 into x equal to 354,018.4 into 1.67 minus 127,446.6 into 1. So, solving this equation, x equal to 2.05 meter. X is the position at which this force is acting. And the reaction between the gates, so R equal to F by 2 into sin theta. So, 226,571.8 divided by 2 into sin theta equal, sin 30 equal to 226,571.8 newton. Now, if you take RT is the reaction at the top of the hinge, top hinge, and RB is the reaction at the bottom hinge, total reaction equal to RT plus RB. So, taking moment of hinge reactions about the bottom hinge, RT into 6 plus RB into 0 equal to 226,571.8. So solving this equation RT, the reaction at the top hinge is 77,400 Newton, and the reaction at the bottom hinge R minus RT equal to 226,571.8 minus 77,412 equal to 149,159.8 Newton. So the force or the reaction at the hinges. So the top hinge, it is 77,412 Newton, and the bottom hinge, it is 149,159.8 Newton. Example number 6, a rectangular pontoon is 6 meter long, 3 meter wide and 1.5 meter high. The depth of immersion of the pontoon is 1 meter in sea water. If the center of gravity is 0.75 meter above the bottom of the pontoon, determine metacentric height. The density of the sea water is taken as 1025 kilograms per meter cube. So this is the, these are all the given data. The dimension of the pontoon, 6 meter by 3 meter by 1.5 meter. Depth of immersion h equal to 0.9 meter. Distance ag equal to 0.75 meter. And density of water is 1025 kilograms per meter cube. Ag center is 0.75 meter. And distance AB, AB equal to H by 2, so which is 1 by 2, which is 1, H equal to 1 meter, 1 by 2 equal to 0.5 meter. And distance BG, BG equal to AG minus AB, which is 0.75 minus 0.5 equal to 0.25. So AB, AG, and G is the center of the pontoon, which is 0.75 meter. The volume of the pontoon immersed, V bar, V equal to 3 into 1 into 6 equal to 18 meter cube. The moment of inertia of the pontoon, I equal to 1 by 12 into 6 into 3 to the power 3, which is 13.5 meter to the power 4. Metacentric height, GM equal to I by volume. So, moment of inertia divided by volume minus BG, which is 13.5 divided by 18 minus 0.25 equal to 0.5 meter. So, the answer to the problem, the metacentric height is 0.5 meter. A solid cylinder of diameter 5 meter has a height of 3 meter. Find the metacentric height of the cylinder when it is floating in water with its axis vertical. The specific gravity of the cylinder metal is 0.65. So, this is the cylinder. So, the height of the cylinder is 3 meter and diameter of the cylinder equal to 5 meter and the specific gravity of the cylinder metal is 0.65. So, now we calculate the depth of immersion of the cylinder, h equal to 0.65 into 3. Which is 1.95 meter. So, 0.65 is the specific gravity, 3 is the total height of the cylinder. And distance AB equal to H by 2, AB equal to H by 2, which is 1.95 divided by 2 equal to 0.975 meter. Distance AG equal to H by capital H divided by 2, which is 3 by 2 equal to 1.5 meter. And the distance BG equal to AG minus AB, which is 1.5 minus 0.975 equal to 0.525 meter. Then again, moment of inertia of the cylindrical body, I equal to pi by 4 d to the power 4, diameter to the power 4, which is pi by 4 into 5 to the power 4 equal to 30.66 meter to the power 4. The volume of the cylinder in water, V equal to pi by 4 d square into h. So, pi by 4 into 5 square into 1.95 equal to 38.27 meter cube. So, the metacentric height GM equal to moment of inertia divided by the volume minus BG. So, which is 30.66 divided by 38.27 minus 5.25 equal to 0.276 meter. So, the answer to the problem, metacentric height equal to 0.276 meter. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject and I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You may find a book of fluid mechanics and machines. You can refer to the book for additional problems and the theory in the subject. So, thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again in another video lecture in the fluid mechanics and machines. Until then, bye-bye.